Hey guys, today is the 1st of January 2061, the start of a wonderful new decade, and I have some exciting news to tell you guys. But Tendai, you look half asleep. Tendai!
Nandi, what time is it? You know I slept late watching the sunrise on our new decade, eh? This better be good. Really good.
Good morning. A happy new year and a new decade to both of you. At least I'm awake. And Nandi, I know you're full of stories. What is it now?
I was looking through some old images of my grandmother Yande from the year 2021, and I found a really exciting journal that she wrote. Let me tell you guys what it contained. The world is getting hotter and hotter by the day. Here in Zambia, we've seen more floods, more droughts, and more storms than ever seen before. And it's affecting our health and food security. My friends Wangani in Malawi and Kudakwashe in Zimbabwe say the exact same thing. I wonder if adults understand that we as young people must inherit this earth after they're gone. This is our only planet. We must protect it.
Okay guys, you know I have my full attention. I'm now up. You know what? My grandfather not only told me how bad it was during those days, but he also showed me pictures which I still have in my gallery. Here guys, take a look. People were using coal and oil, and this led to a blanket of pollution around the earth. And it even led to temperatures increasing, leading to runaway fires in forested areas. The very forests that are the earth's green lungs, that keep the air fresh and the earth cool, were being cut down to pave way for development. It was worse in countries whose economies were growing fast at that time. In his very own words, he said, the earth was struggling to breathe.
Oh my God, there's no way we can go back to that. Look around you. Our economies were small back then and did not play a big part in causing climate change. But from the stories my grandfather told me, they certainly felt its impact. Come on guys, let me show you some of the images I sourced for a school project showing the damage that global warming did to our countries.
Signs of disaster have already begun to manifest in Manicaland provinces, particularly in Chipinge, as strong winds and heavy rains have been witnessed since Thursday evening. Due to the violent nature of the tropical cyclone Idai, panic and fear has already affected Chipinge residents as they fret for their safety and their homes. The rains haven't stopped since Thursday, and this has largely affected business in the central business district of Chipinge, as some shops have closed, while the few that are opened are struggling to avoid flowing waters from entering their shops. Unconfirmed reports saying, some areas in upper and eastern Chipinge have been terribly affected, with homes destroyed and some de-roofed, and in some areas roads have been blocked.
It was very depressing, and it would have got much worse.
You know what, guys? I've had a crazy thought. People were treating the poor earth so badly, so maybe it was a good thing that the earth decided to punish these people with droughts, floods, and even fire. This is when people realized that they needed to stop. Remember, all countries had to sign an agreement and pledge to change. What was the agreement called again?
The Paris Agreement.
Exactly, that's it. You guys are definitely sharper than me this morning. So countries made a decision that they would not use oil, coal, and gas so that they would reduce greenhouse gases. And they did. So slowly global warming decreased. And look at us now. Our countries are so beautiful now. Our streams, our lakes, our game reserves, and our animals, they are healthy. And our economies are booming. Just look at our farms, they're doing very, very well. We grow our food responsibly, and our air is clean. Southern Africa is seen as a leading giant in using clean energy to power its growth and production. Of course, things are not that perfect. We do have our problems. And climate change has not gone away totally. But wow, just look at us now.
We've come a million miles from 2021 when our grandparents were climate change activists. I would hate to think what the world would look like right now if back then countries across Southern Africa, countries across Africa, and countries across the world did not choose to act and protect the climate.
I guess this is a call to action for us to keep on protecting our planet.
Yes, and if we all do this, then we can go far. My grandmother always said that if we as young people come together and unite, we can make a visible difference in this world. Her favorite quote was, "If you want to walk fast, then go alone. But if you want to walk far, then walk together."
Let's plant more trees to reduce carbon dioxide in the atmosphere.
Prepare us with clean sources of energy as a clean generation.
Let's work together to mitigate and adapt effects of climate change.
So this is a historic moment for us as Malawi. We are so privileged and honored to have this kind of a dialogue.
Students are encouraged to ask questions and research and present material on how climate change affects their lives.
How serious is climate change in Switzerland?
Experts say that there will be no more glacier in like 100 years, and that's a huge problem because like there will be a lack of water, and without water we can't live, like obviously.
Not only does this give young people insight into the global impact of this issue, it also connects cultures and countries in finding practical solutions to this crisis.
I, as a student, have many ways how I can do in order to prevent these climate change issues. For example, I can plant trees, I can educate my first students on the consequences of climate change. I may use 3Rs, which are reducing, recycling, and reusing.
From these dialogues, students are empowered to design and run projects within their communities.
I know they came here, you know, with a certain amount of knowledge, but they are living here empowered. You know, they are living here as champions of climate change.
The outcomes of these dialogues have also been presented on international stages, such as COP25, with continued engagement through social media. Today, young people have stepped forward to lead the fight for a sustainable future and are asking for the world to do the same.
Let's plant more trees to reduce carbon dioxide in the atmosphere.
Prepare us with clean sources of energy as a clean generation.
Let's work together to mitigate and adapt the effects of climate change.
Are you giving your young people a voice and a future?
Thanks to the thinking of their generation, we now live in a far better world than they did. So it's up to us now to protect what we inherited for future generations. Scary thought? Well, I guess we might also have grandchildren very soon.
Hallelujah! Amen, brother. I also can't quite picture my grandchildren. But guess what? I will want them to think of me as their hero, not a total washout.
Yes, now you're talking. And you know what I love most? Young people like our grandparents were involved. And as they grew older, they created the new technologies to promote the growth of our countries while being kind to the earth.
It's a new wake-up call for all of us, so we don't have a choice. A new decade, new commitment to continue that struggle.
100% agreed, guys. But can I first go back to sleep?
Hi, my name is Yande and I'm from Zambia. And in case you're wondering, the story that you have just seen is not real. This is our dream for our imagined future.
And hi from me too. I am Wangani Nyirenda from Lilongwe, Malawi. And just like Yande and Kudakwashe, I am a youth climate change activist. I also commit myself 100% to fighting climate change. And in the next episode, you'll hear all about our Bwairako Green Project at a school where I am the youth facilitator. I would want to see the future generations inheriting the world that we saw, and not a world that's been destroyed by us.
Last but not least, I am Kudakwashe Blessing Chikondoa from Harare, Zimbabwe. Well, unlike my imaginary grandson, I'm not as sleepy, hey? Just like my friends, I want to make sure that our children and grandchildren inherit the beautiful world we saw.
At our age, it's not easy to think about having grandchildren, but we now have a picture of what our lives, their lives, our country's lives, and countries across Southern Africa would look like if we do not stop punishing the climate. We must act now.
Hear our call. Our climate is changing.
Unfortunately, for this episode, our time is running out. But you'll be glad to hear that we already have people in our own countries working on exciting projects to adapt to climate change. So make sure that you join us next week as we'll be showing this project. So if you want an idea on a project that you can implement, make sure you don't miss our next episode.
One of the major things for farmers in Zambia, they feel they can't advance because they don't have access to enough fertilizers, which is the farming they know. So it kind of limits them in expanding their business. So we're saying, no, you don't have to rely on fertilizers solely. You can also do natural farming with legumes, animal manures, and get very high yields. You can see behind me how the crops are looking, even though they haven't had any chemicals at all, any fertilizer, any sprays for pests of any kind. But still, we're going to harvest very good crops.